Okay, so we're talking about circular saw safety. I want y'all to understand the objectives of this lesson. The main thing I want y'all to get out of it is I want you to understand and be able to follow the safety rules that pertain to a circular saw. So I'm gonna tell you these rules and try to explain them to you, and I want you to be able to follow them, because it doesn't do much good to know the safety rules if you can't follow them. I'm gonna show you how to safely change a circular saw blade, and I'm also gonna show you how to use a circular saw blade. So we're probably gonna be doing some activities in the shop tomorrow, well, probably Thursday, but very soon. And all I want you to do, all we're gonna do is take you out there and let you use a circular saw for a minute, okay? Then we'll be back in here and we'll do some more safety stuff. But I wanna make sure that we know how to use this circular saw safely, because this is a very dangerous tool, okay? It can be very dangerous if you're not careful and if you don't follow the safety rules. Okay, first and foremost, always wear your safety glasses. If we're in a shop, make sure you're wearing the safety glasses. I always want you to hold the saw firmly. One of the main things that I want you to remember is that when you use this saw to cut, you pull the trigger and let the blade get started before you touch the blade to the wood. If you touch the blade to the wood and then pull the trigger, it's gonna take a big chunk out of your wood and it could go and hit somebody in the eye, or it's just not a good idea. So make sure that you hold this blade out here. See, right now it's in space. And I pull the trigger and then I press forward, okay? That way I get a good smooth cut. Keep the cord clear. I've had students to cut these cords before, and what happens is, okay, this part of the cord that goes to the wall is still hot and there's sparks flying everywhere and it can shock you, and it's just a bad idea. So make sure that the cord is out of the way, not to mention, you know, you got a broken saw, that happens. We can fix it, but it's just better if we don't have to. Now guys, we have, in this class, we have inexperienced people, and sometimes they will change these blades and they won't get them tightened up good. So before you use a saw, always take and just check it, and all you have to do is just tap it a little bit. And you can tell whether or not the blade tighten properly. Always make sure that these blade guards are working properly. This is a lower blade guard, and you can see that it retracts. So what happens is, as you cut the wood, the blade will automatically go up, and when you finish the cut, it'll snap back into place. So make sure that this is working properly before you use the circular saw. And finally, this is another thing that I want to make sure everybody understands. If we're cutting this board, we don't need to have this saw blade all the way down like this, okay? It needs to be sticking down just a little bit, okay? And I'll tell you a story here in a minute about a guy that got hurt because he didn't do that. But make sure it's only sticking down about a quarter of an inch lower than whatever you're cutting, okay? All right, I'm gonna let y'all take just a minute and write all these down on your worksheet, and then I'm gonna talk about them a little bit, because y'all are paying more attention to the PowerPoint than you are to what I'm saying.